Hello friends, myself Sanjesh Patil, and today we are going to have a presentation of Introduction to Automobile and Thermodynamics, that is the remaining part of Unit 1 of Basic Mechanical Engineering. Now contents of this presentation are automobile definition, then classification of automobile, thermodynamics and four laws of thermodynamics that we are going to see. Now let's start with automobiles. An automobile or automotive is a vehicle that is capable of propelling itself. So it has power by which it can move along the way. Since 17th century, several attempts have been made to design and construct a practically operative automobile. Today, automobiles play an unimaginable role in the social, economical and industrial growth of any country. After the introduction of internal combustion engines, an automobile industry has seen a tremendous growth. So in our last presentation we have seen internal combustion, that is IC engines. Okay. Now let's see classification of automobiles, how automobiles are classified. First one is based on purpose. Under that, passenger vehicles, that means automobile that carry passengers, that is bus, passengers, trains, car, etc. Then goods vehicle, these are used for transportation of goods from one place to another, that is goods lorry, goods carrier. Okay. Second classification is based on capacity. Heavy motor vehicle, that means large and bulky motor vehicles such as large trucks, buses, light motor vehicles, small motor vehicles, that is cars, jeeps and medium vehicles. That means relatively medium sized vehicle, that means small trucks, minibuses. So that is based on capacity of the automobile. Third is based on fuel sources used to generate power. Under that, first, petrol engine vehicles, which uses petrol engine, like scooters, car, mopeds, motorcycles. Then diesel engine vehicles like trucks, buses, so they use this diesel engine. Then gas vehicles that use gas turbine as power sources, like turbine power cars. Then solar vehicles powered by solar power, that is solar power cars. We are seeing solar power cars. Then hydrogen vehicles that have hydrogen as a power source. Example is Honda F6 Clarity, that is the example of hydrogen vehicle. Then electric vehicles, automobile that uses electricity as power source. So nowadays we are observing electric cars, electric buses. Okay. Then next is steam engine vehicles. Automotive powered by steam engine, that is steamboat, steam locomotive, steam wagon. Then hybrid vehicles, vehicle that use two or more distinct power sources, that is hybrid buses, hybrid cars like Toyota Prius, Honda Insight. That these are the examples of hybrid vehicles which uses two or more power sources. Then hybrid electric vehicle, the vehicles that uses both IC engine and electrical power source to propel itself. Example is Jaguar CX-75, that is the example of hybrid electric vehicle. Next classification is based on type of transmission. Under that, automatic transmission vehicles, that means automobiles that are capable of changing gear ratios automatically as they move, that is example is automatic transmission cars. So no need to change the gears manually here. Then next is conventional transmission vehicle, automobiles that whose gear ratios have to be changed manually. So conventional transmission vehicles means everything has to be done manually. We have to change the gear or we have to change the speed by using manual intervention. And next is under that semi-automatic transmission vehicle, where vehicles that facilitated manual gear changing with clutch pedal. So we have to use clutch pedal to change the gear, that we know. Then fifth classification is based on number of wheels: two-wheeler, three-wheeler, four-wheeler, six-wheelers. And last classification is based on the side of the drive, that is left-hand drive automobile, a vehicle in which steering wheel is fitted on the left-hand side, that is automobiles found in USA and Russia. And another classification is right-hand drive automobile, where vehicles in which steering wheel is fitted on the right-hand side, that is automobiles found in India or Australia. So these are the various classifications of automobiles, six basic classification on which automobiles can be bifurcated. So this was about automobiles that was mentioned in the syllabus. Now let us see thermodynamics, introduction to thermodynamics. Now thermodynamics can be defined as the study of energy transformation and its relation to matter. So actually in thermodynamics deal with heat, energy, work done. So these types of terms are used in thermodynamics. Okay, so now there are basic four laws of thermodynamics that we are going to see. First one is the zeroth law of thermodynamics. It states that if two systems are in thermodynamic equilibrium with a third system, the two original systems are in thermal equilibrium with each other. So what is meant by thermal equilibrium? So the thermal equilibrium means when the temperature is same throughout the entire system, that we are going to see in next slide. So if the two systems are having same temperature, then they are in thermal equilibrium. So this law states that if two systems are in thermodynamic equilibrium with a third system, then the two original systems are in thermal equilibrium with each other. Example, if system A is in thermal equilibrium with system C, that means temperature of system A is same as that of temperature C, and if system B is also in thermal equilibrium with system C, that is temperature of system B is same as temperature of system C, then system A and system B are in thermal equilibrium with each other. Okay, so now let's see example. So this is the example of two systems, system A and system B. So system A is having temperature of around 10 degrees centigrade and system B is having temperature of 20 degrees centigrade, and these two systems are kept beside each other. So here what will happen, due to temperature difference, there is a heat transfer takes place, that is heat is exchanged. Now from system B, the heat will get passed to system A, that is obvious. Okay, so system B will lose heat and system A will gain heat. So ultimately after some time we will having such type of scenario where system A and system B will having temperature of 15 degree centigrade. So we can say that system A and system B, these two systems are in thermal equilibrium, right? Now, this was the zeroth law of thermodynamics. Next law is first law of thermodynamics. Now, it states that the energy can be converted from one form to another with the interaction of heat, work, and internal energy, but it cannot be created nor destroyed under any circumstances. So, it can be converted from one form to another form. Okay. So, this can be put by a mathematical equation like delta U equal to Q plus W, where delta Q is the total change in internal energy of the system and Q is the heat exchange between a system and its surrounding, and W is the work done by or on the system. So, delta U is equal to Q plus W. So, this was first law. Second law of thermodynamics, it states that the state of entropy of entire universe is an isolated system will always increase over time. The second law also states that the changes in the entropy in the universe can never be negative. That means the heat content of the entire universe as an isolated system will always increase over time. So, in another way, or in Kelvin-Planck statement, it can be put in another way. It is impossible to construct an engine which operates on a cycle and produces no other effect than the transfer of heat from a single body in order to produce work. So, here we can have explanation. So, you can see here, this is a heat source and this is the heat sink, okay, and this is the heat engine. So, heat engine will take the heat from this heat source, that is QH, and heat engine will perform some certain work that will be denoted as W, okay, and after performing the work, the heat engine will lose some heat, that is called as QL. So, what did this Kelvin-Planck statement says, that W is never equal to work. Okay. So, whatever heat is absorbed, that heat, 100% heat, is not converted into work. Okay. Q is not equal to W. Okay. Heat source means heat will be absorbed from this heat source. And heat sink means heat will be rejected to atmosphere or heat sink. Okay. So, here it is explained. In case of heat engine, heat QH is extracted from high temperature source TH. Part of that heat is converted into work W done on the surroundings, and rest is rejected to low temperature sink, that is TL. Right. The opposite occurs here. The opposite occurs for a heat pump, in which work W is done on the system in order to extract heat from QL, here from low temperature source TL, you can see here heat source, and heat pump is used, and this pump is to be the high temperature sink TH. So, exactly opposite to this. So, here heat engine is used, and in this case heat pump is used. And last, third law of thermodynamics. Third law of thermodynamics states that the entropy of a perfect crystal at a temperature of 0 Kelvin, that is absolute zero temperature, is equal to 0. So, what is mean by absolute temperature? The coldest possible temperature, 0 on the Kelvin scale and approximately minus 23 degree centigrade or minus 459 degree Fahrenheit. Here, the total absence of heat is there, the temperature at which motion of all molecules will cease. That is called as absolute zero temperature. So, the third law of thermodynamics states that the entropy of a perfect crystal at a temperature